Yeah, that's a good description of my research, because the digital media landscape and digital media is intricate ecosystem where humans and machines interact, and their response to each other's action creates the entire dynamics. So there is a phenomena called the illusion of truth. Even though people believe this may not be true, if they hear repeatedly, and if they hear it multiple times, because it sounds familiar, they turn to believe it, because familiarity breeds credibility. So people hear some story often and they turn to believe it. And even though it's a small group of people, and if they retweet it, think about all the people connected to them. And they're the friends, they're the people who they know and trust. And that's how this misinformation spreads and trickles down to the regular people. The bots play a critical role in the diffusion stage. But when it comes to the combat stage, when it comes to fighting misinformation, actually the interaction between humans and bots and machines become more evident. This is why. So usually fact-checking happens through the human endeavor. Like fact-checkers that are widely known are PolitiFact, factcheck.org, and Snopes. There is a intensive human labor involved in this process. So computer scientists and programmers, they are trying to develop an AI system that automatically detects misinformation based on certain features. This algorithm that detects misinformation, they play a role of cop. But then what happens is this misinformation and bad actors, they are also AI. The bots are also AI. They learn from cops' behavior. The more they get caught, certain behaviors are detected, they learn quickly, they adapt. Therefore, they constantly change their behavior so that they don't get caught. So here's the problem. It's they both constantly evolve. They try to outbid each other, but the challenge lies right there. It's a difficult to eradicate misinformation or bad actors at all. The reason why I looked at the Amazon algorithm is because, again, because this architecture and how these roadmaps are really important for people to encounter good information. I believe the more as a consumers request the higher standards, they're gonna give it to us. So in the beginning, Facebook, Twitter, and all these platforms argue that we are just mere platform companies. We are not media companies. We have nothing to do with the misinformation. It's you, media, and the consumers, you take care of it. But now they have changed their position, their stance. They're trying to moderate, the foremost. Unfortunately, the priority for this platform company is to increase a customer's engagement. The more they click on their pages, the more items they purchase, the more eyeballs they get. That's their priority. It'll please them. Unfortunately, the public health and public interest is not their priority. So even though they don't favor misinformation, they don't promote misinformation, but the algorithm itself is designed to promote these eyeballs and engagement. We're asking them to design their algorithm to be publicly minded.